हेलो गाइस, वेलकम्स यू। टुडे वी आर कमिंग विद द स्पेशल टॉपिक दैट्स इज शॉक इन चिल्ड्रन। दैट्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन व्यू ऑफ एन इमरजेंसी इन चिल्ड्रन एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। एंड टुडे आर ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस टॉपिक्स आर डेफिनेशन, स्टेजेस ऑफ द शॉक एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द शॉक, एटियोलॉजी ऑफ द शॉक, पैथोफिजियोलॉजी ऑफ द शॉक, diagnosis and how will we treat and management of this shock and complication with the prognosis of the shock. So guys, shock is an acute process which is characterized by the body's inability to deliver the adequate oxygen to meet the metabolic demand. If the adequate oxygen is not supplied according to the metabolic demand, you can see the second picture where the metabolic demand is high than the oxygen delivery, the vitals, organ and tissues having less oxygen supply. So there is inadequate perfusion to the vital organ, that is called as shock. So epidemiologically, approximately 2% of the all hospitalized children having shock in children and adults in developed countries, and mortality rate is varies subsequently depending on the etiology and clinical circumstances of the children. And we'll think here that oxygen delivery to the vital organs is dependent on the arterial oxygen content and cardiac output, where the cardiac output itself is dependent on the stroke volume and heart rate, and stroke volume is dependent on preload, afterload and cardiac contractility, and arterial oxygen content is depend on the oxygen content of the hemoglobin and plasma oxygen solution. And arterial blood pressure is maintained with the cardiac output and peripheral vascular resistance. So guys, the factor that affecting the oxygen deliveries are arterial oxygen content and cardiac output, where the arterial oxygen content is dependent on the hemoglobin oxygen or oxygenated hemoglobin and oxygen supply to the plasma, and the oxygenation supply of the plasma is influenced by the aortic arterial gradient, DPZ, acid base balance, blockers, competitive and temperature, while the cardiac output is dependent on the heart rate and stroke volume, where the heart rate is influenced by the any drugs or conductive system, and stroke volume is dependent on the ventricular compliances, which is dependent on the end diastolic pressure, which is maintained by the CVP, venous volume and venous tone. And ventricular compliance is also dependent on the end systolic volume, which is dependent on the cardiac contractility, which is influenced by the metabolic milieu, any ions, acid base balance, temperature, drugs, toxins, and it also dependent or influenced by the afterload, temperature, drugs, blockers, competitive and autonomic tones. So guys, we comes to the stages of the shock. So initially, if there is an insult via the an injury, that it may trigger the shock, and body itself attempt to preserve the oxygenation perfusion to the vital organ, which are the brain, heart, kidney, liver or adrenals. That's called as the non-progressive or stages of the compensation, where the compensatory mechanism developed. And if there is shock progresses continue and increased tissue oxygen extraction and unable to compensate for this, the deficiency in the oxygen delivery that lead to the progressive of the clinical deterioration and lactic acidosis will be there, that may cause circulatory failure with the end organ dysfunction and known as uncompensated or decompensated stage of the shock. In their stage, there will be tissue damage, and if untreated, there may be multiple organ dysfunction failure modes is there, and it will be as irreversible shock, एंड अल्टीमेटली मे कॉज ऑर्गन इंजरी और डेथ. सो गाइस, व्हाट साइंस कैन बी सीन इन द डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ द शॉक. इन केस ऑफ द कंपनसेटेड स्टेट स्टेजेस देर इज हाइपोटेंशन, टैकीकार्डिया, नैरो पल्स प्रेशर विल बी देयर, पेरिफेरल वैसोकॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन विल बी देयर. इन केस ऑफ द डीकंपनसेटेड और अनकंपनसेटेड शॉक देर विल बी टैकीपनिया, अल्टर्ड मेंटल स्टेसिस, डिक्रीज यूरिन आउटपुट विल बी देयर एंड मायोकार्डियल इस्केमिया विल बी देयर. इन केस ऑफ इररिवर्सिबल स्टेज देर विल बी मेटाबॉलिक डीरेंजमेंट विद द टिश्यू परफ्यूजन इज क्रिटिकली रिड्यूस्ड इन द वाइटल ऑर्गन्स एज ब्रेन, हार्ट और किडनी, एड्रिनल एक्सेट्रा एंड लैक्टिक एसिडोसिस विल बी देयर विद द हाइपोथर्मिया एंड कोगुलोपैथी. सो गाइस, वी शुड डिफ्रेंशिएट द कोल्ड शॉक एंड वार्म शॉक स्टेजेस. इन अर्ली स्टेज देर विल बी ए वार्म शॉक वेयर द पेरिफेरल वैस्कुलर रेजिस्टेंस विल बी डिक्रीज एंड ड्यू टू विच देर विल बी इंक्रीज कार्डियो आउटपुट एंड पल्स प्रेशर विल बी वाइड. वाइल इन द लेटर स्टेज दैट मे बी कोल्ड स्टेज और कोल्ड शॉक वेयर द इंक्रीज पेरिफेरल वैस्कुलर रेजिस्टेंस अलॉन्ग विद द डिक्रीज स्ट्रोक वॉल्यूम और डिक्रीज कार्डियक आउटपुट विद द इम्पेयरमेंट ऑफ द प्रीलोड, आफ्टरलोड और कार्डियक कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी. सो गाइस, शॉक इज क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इटियोलॉजी इन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ शॉक एज हाइपोवॉल्यूमिक शॉक, एज कार्डियोजेनिक शॉक, डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव शॉक, सेप्टिक शॉक एंड ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव शॉक. एंड इटियोलॉजिकली हाइपोवॉल्यूमिक शॉक इज caused by the any blood loss due to the hemorrhage or any injury, any plasma losses due to the any burn in nephrotic syndrome or water or electrolyte shock due to the any vomiting or diarrhea. Cardiogenic shock may be due to the congenital heart diseases, any cardiomyopathy due to the infections, any acquired cardiomyopathy, dilated cardiomyopathy or restrictive cardiomyopathy. There may be some ischemia or arrhythmia also. In distributive, there will be post spinal injury or brain stem injury that is due to spinal shock, and there may be some anaphylactic shock due to the drug reaction or drug allergy or any poison. Septic shock may be due to the any infection caused by the bacterial infection, viral infection or fungal infection. That is more or there is increased risk in immunocompromised patient. And obstructive cause of shock is due to the tension pneumothorax. You can see here that there is obstruction and pericardial tamponade may be there, pulmonary embolism or anterior mediastinal mass or any coarctation of aorta that may cause compression on the heart. So guys, we will come to the pathophysiology of shock, where the acute circulatory failure will be there, and if there is low volume due to any causes of the blood loss, plasma loss or water or electrolyte loss, there will be decreased preload which may cause low stroke volume. Finally, it causes decreased cardiac output which cause hypovolemic shock, and if there is pump failure may cause poor myocardial contractility which cause low stroke volume, whereas decreased cardiac output cause cardiogenic shock. Or due to the poor myocardial contractility there will be increased left ventricular filling pressure or increased left arterial pressure which cause increased pulmonary capillary pressure which cause pulmonary edema, ultimately cause cardiogenic shock. And if there is low basal tone or decreased tone in the basals may cause capillary leaking which cause venous pooling, due to this there will be decreased preload which cause decreased cardiac output, or there may be fluid distribution which cause distributive shock. As you know, if there is any infection or systemic inflammatory response syndrome which cause mediator release like the interleukins, TNF alphas, others may cause composition of complex of the shock due to the hypovolemic, cardiogenic or distributive shock which cause septic shock. Or if there is any obstruction of the blood flow may cause low cardiac output which having obstructive shock. So guys, what are the clinical manifestation? It's dependent on the etiology of the shock, but if etiology is unrecognized and untreated, a common progression of the clinical signs and pathophysiological changes in the shock is seen, which cause irreversible organ injury and may cause death. In case of the hypovolemic shock, there is orthostatic hypotension, dry mucous membrane, dry axilla, poor skin turgor, decreased urine output, normal or slightly cool distal extremities, and pulses may be normal or decrease or increase, there may be tachycardia. In case of the cardiogenic shock, there will be tachypnea, extremities will be cool, delayed capillary filling time or poor or peripheral or central pulses, decline mental status and decrease urinary output, decrease cardiac output and peripheral vasoconstriction will be there. In case of distributive shock, there will be peripheral vasodilation due to this distribution of the blood flow change, and there will be increase but inadequate cardiac output. In case of the septic shock, there will be seen as bacteremia or septicemia, and systemic inflammatory response syndrome is known as if there is two signs along with any one of core temperature or counts out of four, that is core temperature is more than 38.5 degree or less than 36 degree centigrade, heart rate is more than 2 standard deviation for the normal, or tachycardia, respiratory rate or tachypnea is as more than 2 standard deviation for the normal age and sex, and counts is more than 12,000 per millimeter cube or less than 4,000 per millimeter cube, along with or associated with 10% immature band cells. And obstructive, there may be inadequate cardiac output with physical restriction of the forward blood flow along with the cardiac arrest. So guys, what signs of the decreased perfusion can be seen on the basis of mild, moderate or severe perfusion? There is some involvement of the organ system. Like in mild perfusion, you can see in the kidney, skin or cardiovascular system changes where the urinary volume is decreased along with the specific gravity of the urinary system is increased, or there may be decrease or delayed increase capillary refilling time, or delayed capillary refilling time is more than 2 to 3 seconds, or there may be tachycardia or heart rate. So guys, if you find any tachycardia or decreased urinary volume, you should think about the impedance of the shock, or there may be mild stage of decreased perfusion. In case of moderate decreased perfusion, there may be patient will be restlessness, apathic or anxious, where the increase ventilation or respiratory rate is increased, or tachypnea with the compensated metabolic acidemia or lactic acidosis with the decrease gut motility, or oliguria may be there with the less than 0.5 milliliter per kg per hour, and extremities or skin peripheries cool or cold extremities, or cardiovascular system having increased heart rate with the tachycardia or decreased peripheral pulses. In severe perfusion, severe decrease of the perfusion, the patient will be agitated or confused with stupors or maybe stages of the coma with the increased ventilation, or severe tachypnea with uncompensated metabolic acidemia with gut ileus, or there may be oliguria or anuria, skin may be mottled or cyanotic with the cold extremities, or tachycardia with decreased blood pressure may be found in case of the severe decreased perfusion. Guys, hemodynamically we assess the shock on the basis of preload, afterload, contractility or cardiac output, where in the cardiogenic shock there is the preload and afterload is increased while the cardiac contractility is decreased due to this cardiac output is also decreased. In case of the hypovolemic shock, their preload is decreased due to which afterload is compensatory increase and cardiac contractility is not affected here along with the decreased cardiac output. In septic shock, there is an early stage or warm stage, there will be preload and afterload both are decreased with the no affection on the cardiac contractility, with the cardiac output initially increased to compensate the perfusion of the vital organ. In later stage or late stage, where in the cold stage, preload and afterload both are increased with the cardiac contractility is decreased and cardiac output is also decreased. In case of the obstructive stage, their preload is decreased while the afterload is increased and cardiac contractility is decreased and cardiac output is decreased. In distributive shock, you can see their preload and afterload both are decreased along with the increased cardiac contractility, or cardiac output may be normal in case of this type of shock. So guys, whenever you find a type of shock or any stages of shock, you should think about the management of shock, and this is very important. Initially, overall, we should think the goal having increased oxygen delivery to the vital organ and decrease the demand of oxygen. So treatment is done by the increased oxygen content of the blood, and there may be due to the with the increased cardiac output, or may sedate or analgesic can be given to decrease the oxygen demand, and blood pressure can be increased by the inotropes or other drugs. So guys, what principle should be taken, which is initially we should maintain the ABC, is there is airway should be patent, and if required intubation to be done, and in breathing there should be adequate ventilation and oxygenation to the child, and circulation should be done by the initially IV or intraosseous cannulation to be done and optimize the cardiac function and oxygenation by the increased circulation. So guys, we should act quickly and think slowly in case of the shock. So do fast and think along with the work. So therapeutically, stroke volume can be increased by the increased preload, afterload or contractility, where the preload is can be increased by the volume or maintaining CBP, and afterload can be increased by the vasodilator or vasoconstrictor drugs, and cardiac contractility may be correct by the acidosis, by the correction of the hypoxia or correction of the hypoglycemia, and inotropic agent can be used. Cardiac output can also be increased by the heart rate, and that can be done by the vagolysis or chemotherapy. So guys, there is an algorithm which is goal directed step wise management of the hemodynamic support. In infant and children, there is an 0 minute, or there is an initial or immediate management to be taken if there is decreased mental status or there is decreased perfusion. Assess IV or intraosseous immediately, and within 5 minutes you should give the 20 ml per kg normal saline bolus, and you should assess the hepatomegaly if there, stop the IV fluid. If hepatomegaly is not present, IV fluid continue. If perfusion is not increased by the 1 bolus, 3 boluses of 20 ml per kg can be given, maximum up to 60 ml per kg. Along with, you should take the blood sugar level. If there is hypoglycemia, it should be treat, or antibiotics should be start empirically. Along with it, you should assess the hepatomegaly or if there is any crackles or rails in the lungs. If with the giving this bolus, a patient is not compensated or not revert back, that is called as fluid refractory shock in 15 minutes. That can be treated by the intraosseous or intravenous inotrop. That preferably epinephrine should be given as 0.05 to 0.3 microgram per kilogram per minute, and you should assess the central venous pressure or airway, and you should titrate the epinephrine at the rate of 0.05 to 0.3 microgram per kilogram per minute for the cold shock. If there is warm shock, norepinephrine can be preferred. If epinephrine and norepinephrine are not available, dopamine can be used for the titration. In 60 minutes, if there is no reversible of the shock, this is called as catecholamine resistant shock, which should be treated urgently, and they think about the at-risk adrenal insufficiency and use the Doppler ultrasound, PICO, FETD or to PAC to the direct fluid. Inotropes can be used, vasopressor and vasodilator may be used. Our overall goal to be maintain the mean arterial pressure and CVP and SCVO2 is more than 70%, which is venous oxygen saturation, and cardiac index should be 3.3 to 6 liter per minute per meter square. If there is normal blood pressure or stages of the cold shock with the SCVO2 is less than 70% along with the hemoglobin is more than 10 per deciliter on epinephrine, we should begin milrinone infusion and we can add nitrovasodilator. If cardiac index is less than 3.3, we can consider levosimendan. If there is blood pressure is low along with the cold shock or SCVO2 is less than 70% along with the hemoglobin is more than 10 on epinephrine, we can add norepinephrine to attain the normal blood pressure. If there is cardiac index is less than 3.3, we can add dopamine or levosimendone. If there is low blood pressure along with the warm shock or there is SCVO2 is less than 70% with hemoglobin is more than 10 on norepinephrine. If euvolemic, add vasopressin, terlipressin or angiotensin. If cardiac index on these drugs is less than 3.3, we can add dobutamine and levosimendone. If patient is not treated with these drugs or not reverse, it's known as persistent catecholamine resistant shock. In this condition, we should evaluate the pericardial effusion or maybe their pneumothorax and maintain mean arterial pressure is less than 12 millimeter per hg. If there is no maintain with this stage is called as refractory shock, and in this case ECMO therapy may be required. So guys, the prognosis of shock is dependent on the child age and etiology. In case of the septic shock, there is mortality rate is as low as in 3% is in case of the healthy children and may be increase 6 to 9% in children with the chronic illness, whereas in the adult age there may be 25 to 30% in case of the adult. With the early recognition and the therapy, the mortality rate is continues to improve, but the shock and MORTS remain one of the leading cause of death in case of the infant and children. And The risk of the death involve a complex interaction of the factor including the underlying etiology, presence of the chronic illness, host immune response and timing of the recognition of the therapy. So guys, how was the topic? If the topic is clear, then you can treat the shock at the any level of the PSC, CSC or medical college level. So guys, this is very important topic and it will help you in help you to treat the patient at any level. You can treat the shock in a children very effectively. In the early golden hour, you should treat the shock. So guys, like the video, share the video and subscribe the channel if you not done yet to get the early notification of our channel. Thank you.